Okay, well, think about it. There's different types of wingmen, just as there are different types of birds. So all wingmen techniques stem from types of birds. That's why they're called wingmen. Trust me, you guys would have definitely done these techniques when you've been out and about before. Let's start with the kookaburra. So this is where the friend, or the wingman of the friend, laughs outrageously at everything he says to make him seem funny to a group of girls nearby. So Kenny, you'll say something like,
"So then I said, that's not a dog, that's my mother."
And then Tom will do a massive over-the-top laugh.
"Lol, rufflecopter."
And then say something like,
"You're not a little freak at all, Kenny. You're hilarious."
And this is where the girls catch on, right?
"That guy sounds very funny."
And then all of a sudden, you're in the cubicle with her, Ken.
"I like this."
I thought you might. Let's move on to the next one then. The parrot. So this is for a socially awkward guy, kind of like you. You basically go back to back with a guy that is really, really cool. He says something like,
"Hey darling, what's your favourite type of cheese?"
Tom, being the parrot, mimics you.
"Hey darling, what's your favourite type of cheese?"
All of a sudden, Tom's in the cubicle with a girl. Got your attention yet, fellas?
Yes.
Let's move on to an Australian bird, one that a lot of people hate, the magpie. Tom, say you'll be talking to a girl. Your wingman's over in the corner of the room, you're giving him thumbs up, he's giving you thumbs up, she's giving him thumbs up, you're giving her thumbs up, she's giving herself thumbs up. Everyone's just thumbs upping each other. So everything's going great, but then all of a sudden, in comes an incredibly handsome man. Like, I can't describe it. He has a moustache, he's got a tiger shirt, he's 6 foot tall, he's just amazing. So you've got no chance. This girl is fixated on this guy. She's made her decision, she's going home with him tonight. All of a sudden, the wingman notices this and just full magpie mode, starts squawking and running around and pecking this guy's head. You're attacking him as a magpie. He has no choice but to leave. He can't stand getting attacked by a magpie. There you go, the girl's yours again. Let's move over to Africa. This one is the flamingo. So the flamingo is a pink, beautiful bird. Tom, in this instance, you can be the flamingo. This is where you pretend to be gay. You walk over, you say something like,
"Hey ladies, this is Ken. He's got a Mazda 3, his own property, and a pretty big penis. I'd have him for myself, but unfortunately, he's straight. Ew."
You make him look really good, right? Then you kind of sassily walk off, you shaking your bum and clicking your fingers like you do.
"Gotta go."
He must be a catch. Gay guys never lie. That's one of their things. "Oh my God, should we reward him for being such a nice guy?" Yeah.
Two girls with you in the cubicle, Kenny. Two girls. That's how effective the flamingo is. Guys, I don't have time for much more, so I'll tell you one more. This one is the ibis. So Tom, what you do is you walk in and you have a straw hanging out your mouth, kind of like the beak of an ibis. And then all of a sudden, Kenny's talking to a girl. She's holding a drink. You go over her shoulder, like an ibis going into a bin, and start sucking the drink out of her cup. And she's like, "Oh my God." Then you walk off. Kenny says,
"Gaw blimey, gee willikers, did you see that bloke have a sip of your drink? That's disgusting."
"By comparison, you're not even nearly as disgusting as that guy."
And then you can guess what happens next, Kenny.
Cubicle, yeah.
Fellas, that is 5 nights in a row. You've used bird-like wingman techniques and you've pulled girls in the cubicle.
Oh my God, that guy laughs like a kookaburra. Those guys are such losers.
Would you like to see a cockatoo?
Three.
They're looking this way.